The Myphitic Blight-hauler is a disgusting Nurgle demon engine that provides the Death Guard with heavy firepower, and in this video we're going to show you how to paint one in the colours of the Tainted Sons Vectorum using the contrast method, and we'll paint the model up to battle ready. As with any miniature, the first thing that you need to do is to undercoat your model using some spray, or you can paint it on by hand, but the colour you want for this is Wraithbone, which you can see is what I've sprayed my miniature with just here. As I said, you could paint it on by hand instead if you choose to do so, but either way, once you've done that, you're then ready to start painting it with some contrast paints. And the first one that we need is Militarum Green. Now I'm going to be applying this using a medium shade brush, and what I'm going to be doing here is just getting some of the paint out of the pot and putting it onto the palette to allow me to control exactly how much of this I'm applying at once. And to begin with, we want to put on quite a lot, so I'm just going to build up a little puddle there like that to draw from, and there we go. Then it's just a matter of painting this onto the armour on our miniature. Now at this stage you don't need to worry about being too neat, but what we need to make sure that we do is cover the armour plating, such as around here, and also bring it onto the trim as well, such as these parts just along here. Now these other details, such as the eye and things, like I said, don't worry about catching those because we will neaten up later. For the time being, just concentrate on that armour plating. Once the Militarum Green is completely dry, you're then ready to move on to applying the next two contrast paints to the miniature. And these two next paints are actually very strong colours, which we can paint directly over the top of the green, so now is a great opportunity for them. First of all, we need Gorgrunter Fur. This is going to be for all that rusty trim, and then we're going to move on to Black Templar for all the black details. But first of all, we need Gorgrunter Fur, and I'm going to be applying this using a medium layer brush because we need a little bit more control now where we're applying this exactly. So use the palette again to make sure that your brush isn't overloaded. And there we go, you don't need to thin it down with any water at all. But what I'm looking to do is to paint all that trim detail going around the armour. So the really obvious example is this trim running around the front here. What I'll do is just carefully start applying it like this, as being as neat as I can when I get up to that edge along there like that. Now whilst you're doing this, also keep an eye out for any other bronze details and be sure to paint them with this colour at this stage. And once you've finished painting in all that trim, you're then ready to apply a little bit of Black Templar for all the cables. For example, the ones round here. Now this stage is also a few other details to paint black, and that involves the stinger that we've got back here, and also the warheads on the missiles. I finished applying the Black Templar, and now we've painted on all the more strong contrast colours to the miniature, and what we need to do now is get prepared for some of the lighter ones, and for this we need to return to Wraithbone just to neaten up any details we've splodged onto them by accident. Now with this paint I'm going to be using the medium layer brush, and this time when we use the palette you need to make sure that you thin the paint down with a little bit of water, just to make it a little bit smoother, give you more control over it and help it dry smoother as well. So you don't need very much, just a small amount mixed in there like that, just to dilute it down a little bit. Then just twist your brush to get rid of the excess paint and bring the bristles to a nice point. And then all you need to do is start looking around the miniature for any details that we've not yet actually painted, just in case you've got any paint splodged on them, and neaten them up. So for example, around the face here, you can see we've got the eye, we've got the silver around it, and also the flesh. But I've got some of the green caught on it, so what I'm going to do is just repaint this over those areas like that, just being as neat as I can around the features that we've already painted. Once that Wraithbone is all neatened up, you're then ready to apply the remaining contrast paints to the miniature, starting out with Basilicanum Grey, which is going to be for all the silver details, and then moving on to Skeleton Horde for the small amounts of bone on the miniature. After that, we'll need Gulliman Flesh to paint in all that disgusting flesh on the model, and then a small amount of Magos Purple for the mandibles, followed by Blood Angels Red for the eye lens. But first of all, we're going to be applying Basilicanum Grey, once again with a medium layer brush, and as before, use the palette to help control how much paint you have on there. And once your brush is loaded up, all you've got to do is start looking for all those silver details. And these are scattered all across the miniature, but generally looking at things such as the mechanical parts, for example, the wheels and the tracks around here. The next colour to apply is Skeleton Horde, and that is for the bone details, which are all along the top of the miniature along here. With the bone now painted, we're ready to move on to painting in all the flesh using Gulliman Flesh, and the large majority of it is around here, but there are some smaller areas of it as well. If you're struggling to get to them, then just switch down to a small airbrush to access the smaller details. With all that disgusting flesh now painted, we're ready to move on to the mandibles, for which we need Magos Purple, and that's these details just around here, as always being neat around the areas that you've completed so far. And finally, using Blood Angels Red, painting the eye lens on the front here, and also the small targeting lens up the top here. And with that, we've now finished applying all the contrast paints to the miniature, and all we need to do now is to put some texture on the base. And for this, we're going to be using a Grelum Badland. Now, to apply this kind of paint, what you need is one of these texture tools, and to use it, you just get the shovel side and get a good scoop of the paint like this, then find an open spot on the base of your miniature and just apply it to it. So, for example, around about here. Then all you've got to do is start pushing the paint around to cover the top of the base. Now, when you get close to the miniature, just switch around to the narrower side of the tool so you have a little bit more control. But on this miniature, you need to be careful when you're doing this because, well, as you can see, is very close to the ground, so it can be a little bit tricky to get underneath it, especially around there. So just take your time as you're applying it there. Now, this paint will take around about an hour to dry, and once it is completely dry, all you need to do is paint the rim of the base. And this can be any colour you like, but for this miniature, I'm going to use Steel Legion Drab. And with the texture paint now completely dry and the rim of the base now painted, the Myphitic Blight-haulers is now battle ready. So when you're painting a model like this, there's two real key things to remember. And the first is that a lot of the contrast paints are quite light colours that require a nice neat undercoat of Wraithbone before you apply them. So just be sure to neaten up those areas with Wraithbone before you put those colours on. The second thing is when you're applying texture paint to the base of the miniature, it can be a little bit tricky to get underneath the main body of it. So be sure to switch the tool around to the narrower side to give you a little bit more control. But really, those are the two key things to remember. So we really hope that you've enjoyed this video, and we'll see you all again very soon.